Dear students, welcome back to MNR's digital classes. The topic of today's lecture is single stage CE amplifier. The reference books used for this in developing this content is, one is Basic Electronics by V.K. Mehta, other one is Modern Physics by R. Murugesan. Single stage CE amplifier. Any transistor circuit, amplifier circuit is said to be single stage transistor amplifier if it is associated with only one transistor. Generally, most of the practical CE amplifier circuits consist of more than one stage of amplifier sections, and they are called as multi-stage transistor amplifiers. Now, in this session, we are going to understand how to construct a practical CE amplifier circuit and the working of various circuit elements used in the design. In order to achieve faithful amplification, we have to choose the proper circuit elements. The circuit shows the practical circuit elements used in the construction of CE amplifier. These circuit elements consist of a biasing circuit, input capacitor, bypass capacitor and coupling capacitor. R1, R2 along with RE forms the biasing circuit with stabilization. C1 forms the input capacitor. C3 forms the emitter bypass capacitor and C2 forms the coupling capacitor. RC is the collector load resistance. This is the designing of practical CE amplifier. Let us understand the working of various circuit components used in the design of CE amplifier. The first one, biasing circuit. The biasing circuit consists of resistors R1, R2 along with RE. R1, R2 forms the biasing network and RE forms the stabilizing circuit. The biasing circuit must establish a proper operating point. Otherwise, a part of the negative half cycle of the signal may be cut off in the output. We know that in order to achieve amplification, the transistor circuit must be always in the active region. To achieve that, the operating point should be always at the midpoint of the load line. Therefore, we have to choose the proper values of R1 and R2 such that the transistor circuit is always in the active region. The second one is input capacitor. Input capacitor is an electrolytic capacitor, usually of the order of 10 microfarad, is used to couple the AC input signal voltage to the base of the transistor. This C1 is used to couple the signal voltage with the base of the transistor. Now, suppose if this C1 is not used, then what happens is the resistance of the source RS comes in parallel with the load biasing resistance R2, which leads to reduction in the effective value of R2. Therefore, the biasing conditions gets disturbed, which may lead to shift in the operating point. Therefore, C1, if you use C1, C1 allows only AC from the signal source, and the signal AC signal will flow to the base without disturbing the biasing conditions of the transistor. The next one is emitter bypass capacitor. Again, this emitter bypass capacitor is an electrolytic capacitor having the value around 100 microfarad. This emitter bypass capacitor is connected in parallel with the emitter resistance RE to provide low resistance path for the output signal. Now, if this is not used in the circuit, then the output current simply passes through the emitter resistance which provides the negative feedback, which leads to reduction in the amplification of the signal. In next session, in the next section, we are going to discuss the role of the CE amplifier. The fourth circuit component is coupling capacitor, represented by C2. Again, the C2 is an electrolytic capacitor having the capacitance 10 microfarad. This is used to couple one stage of amplifier to the next stage. Usually, most of the practical amplifier circuits are multi-stage. So, in order to couple the signal from one stage to the next stage, we use a coupling capacitor C2. Suppose if this coupling capacitor is not used, then the collector resistance RC of one stage comes in parallel with the biasing resistance R1 of the next stage, which decreases, which alters the biasing conditions of the transistor and hence leads to unfaithful amplification. So this coupling capacitor is used to couple the signal, output signal of one stage as input signal to the next stage without altering the biasing condition. Now let us understand working of this CE amplifier. When a weak signal is applied to the base of the transistor, a small base current passes through the input part of the circuit, and because of the transistor action, a much larger collector current flows through the collector load resistance. As the value of RC is quite large, the large voltage drop appears across the collector resistance. Thus, a weak signal fed to the input circuit gets amplified in the form of collector emitter voltage. In this way, the transistor acts as an amplifier. Now let us understand the working of CE amplifier by using this small video game.
Single-stage CE amplifier. Animation shows a single-stage CE amplifier. The different circuit elements and their functions are described as follows. Biasing circuit. The resistances R1, R2, and RE from the biasing and stabilization circuit. Input capacitance, Cin. This is used to couple the signal to the base of the transistor. If this is not used, the signal source resistance will come across R2 and thus change the bias. The capacitor Cin allows only AC signal to flow. Emitter bypass capacitor CE. This is connected in parallel with RE to provide a low resistance path to the amplified AC signal. If it is not used, then amplified AC signal flowing through RE will cause a voltage drop across it, thereby shifting the output voltage. Coupling capacitor C. This is used to couple the amplified signal to the output device. This capacitor C allows only AC signal to flow. Working of the single stage CE amplifier. When a weak input AC signal is applied to the base of the transistor, a small base current flows. Due to the transistor action, a much larger AC current flows through the collector load RC. A large voltage appears across RC and hence at the output. Therefore, a weak signal applied to the base appears in amplified form in the collector circuit. Voltage gain AV of the amplifier is the ratio of the amplified output voltage to the input voltage.
Now come back. Now let us understand the role of emitter resistance in the CE amplifier circuit. To understand the role of emitter resistance, first let us draw the DC equivalent circuit of C amplifier circuit. In order to draw the DC equivalent circuit, we have to consider only the DC components present in the circuit. All the AC components that may be present in the circuit should be eliminated. The procedure to draw the DC equivalent circuit is as follows. First, reduce all the AC sources to zero. First step. Second step, open up all the capacitors. This is because capacitor provides infinite reactance to the flow of DC. Hence, the capacitors will not play any role in the DC analysis or DC equivalent. Therefore, they should be opened up. And all the AC sources should be eliminated or they are putting a shunt. Now let us understand how to draw this DC equivalent circuit. First step, here we have one AC source. So this has to be eliminated by putting a shunt. Now observe where this is eliminated. The next step is to open up all the capacitors. Now observe where we have three capacitors, C1, C2 and C3. All the three are opened and they simply disconnected. When they are disconnected, now observe here, this part gets eliminated. This part gets eliminated. This is eliminated. So we are left out with only the four resistors with the transistor. So only this part of the circuit is left out. The equivalent DC equivalent circuit of C amplifier is as shown here. Now we shall understand the role of emitter bypass capacitor. That is why RE is used in the CE amplifier. To understand this, now let us redraw the transistor DC equivalent circuit of CE amplifier. The DC equivalent circuit consists of R1, R2, RC, and RE. The current flowing through the base is IB, base current. Current through the collector is IC. Current through the emitter resistance is IE. You know that for small signal approximation, collector current and approximately equal to emitter current when base current is negligibly small. Now let us consider a situation when the temperature of the transistor increases. We know that as the temperature increases, the conductivity increases, that is IC increases. When IC increases, it implies IE also increases. Therefore, the voltage drop across the emitter resistance, which is equal to IE into RE, which is approximately equal to IC into R. This increases. We know that this emitter voltage provides negative feedback to the amplifier, to the input. As a result of this negative feedback, the resultant input voltage is given by signal voltage Vs minus this feedback voltage Ve. So this leads to decrease in base current. As the base current decreases, the collector current, which is equal to beta times IB. So as the IB decreases, collector current also decreases. So the conclusion is, whenever there is a change in collector current with the increase in temperature, this will lead to increase in the emitter voltage, which leads to negative feedback. And it decreases the input voltage, and hence base current decreases and collector current decreases. So conclusion is, whenever there is a change in collector current, that change in collector current is automatically adjusted by using emitter resistance. So this emitter resistance is very essential in proper maintenance of the operating point, a stable operating point, and hence emitter resistance provides stabilization to the transistor amplifier circuit. So from this simple discussion, it is very clear that whenever there is a shift in collector current due to temperature changes, the emitter resistance automatically changes the input current and corresponding shift in collector volt current to the original value. And hence, emitter resistance plays an important role in producing stability to the operating point. Now we shall understand the role of bypass capacitor in the CE amplifier circuit. To understand the role of bypass capacitor in CE amplifier circuit, first let us draw the AC equivalent circuit of this CE amplifier. We know that both DC and AC conditions prevail in a transistor amplifier. When no signal is applied to the DC base current, collector current and emitter current flows through the biasing circuit. When the signal is applied, the AC base current, AC collector current and AC emitter current will flow through the circuit. However, the total current in any branch of the circuit is equal to sum of DC and AC currents flowing through the respective branches. To draw the equivalent AC circuit of the transistor, draw the AC equivalent circuit of the transistor amplifier, we shall consider only the AC conditions. In order to achieve the AC conditions only, reduce the DC sources to zero. If there is any DC voltage, reduce that to zero, and all the capacitors should be short circuited. This is because a capacitor offers low reactive power for AC signals depending on their frequency. So there, for small signal analysis where the frequencies are small, the capacitive reactance is almost tends to zero, though it is simply equal to shorting the capacitors. So in the circuit, we have one DC power supply represented by VCC that should be reduced to zero. Now let us understand how to achieve this, how to achieve the DC AC biasing conditions. By shorting all the AC sources, DC sources and capacitors, C1 is shorted, C2 is shorted, C3 is shorted, and this VCC is connected to the ground. Positive and negative are shorted. So the equivalent circuit reduces to R1 is shorted, R2 is shorted to ground, and then coupling C1 input capacitor, C2 output capacitor, and emitter capacitor are shorted. Since C is shorted, emitter resistance is eliminated. This represents AC equivalent circuit of CE amplifier. Now let us understand this. To understand the role of bypass capacitor in CE amplifier, consider the AC equivalent of CE amplifier circuit. As we discussed already, all the DC components are shorted and capacitors are shorted. The circuit looks like this. The effective resistance of R1 and R2 is taken as RB. RB is the effective resistance of R1 and R2, that is equal to R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Now, let us consider the AC equivalent circuit without the emitter capacitor. Let us assume that bypass capacitor is not connected. In that case, we have to retain the emitter resistance. The equivalent circuit of this part is like this. This is RE, collector current, base current. Now, when the temperature increases, the collector current increases, therefore the collector emitter voltage increases, which increases the feedback. So as the feedback signal increases, we already learned in the DC part that input voltage decreases, which leads to decrease in base current, and hence the collector current also decreases. So the emitter resistance provides stability to the operating point in DC current, and it is very essential. Whereas when the input current decreases, the output current also decreases, which reduces the amplification factor. So basically, transistor is an amplifier. It need to amplify the signal. So if it decreases the amplification factor, so it is useless. So this emitter resistance, it is needed, but it does not need it, because in DC part it is required. So for providing the stability. But if you use the emitter resistance to provide the stability, it will lead to decrease in amplification factor. So we have to retain this, but we have to use this properly. So how to use the emitter resistance without decreasing the amplification factor? So that can be achieved by simple technique. Use an emitter capacitor across the emitter resistance. Now consider an emitter resistance. So when we use the emitter resistance, emitter capacitor, that is the bypass capacitor, across the RE, what happens? Since in the AC part, this part gets shorted, because capacitor offers zero reactance, almost practically zero reactance to the flow of AC for small frequency signals. So whatever the output current, amplified AC signal flowing through the RE, when a bypass capacitor is connected, this current simply flows through the coupling capacitor, bypass capacitor. No current practically flows through the emitter resistance. So the biasing conditions are retained, the stability is retained, but still the amplification factor remains unchanged. So this emitter capacitor, the bypass capacitor, bypasses all the AC signals without altering the amplification signal. So we can conclude that the role of bypass capacitor, that is CE, is to bypass the output from the emitter resistance by providing a low resistance path and leads to higher amplification. This is about